This is September 27th, 2020, and we're doing the story of Noah's Ark. So, a while after creation, after there had been a lot of people who had been born on the earth and cities had been built, God looked back down at his creation and he saw that everyone had become very wicked and there were many evil things happening on the earth, and that made him very sad. He looked and looked, and he finally found one man who was righteous and who did what was right and followed God. And that man's name was Noah. And so God said to Noah, "I want you to build a big boat, an ark, so that all the animals and you and your wife and your children can go into the ark, because I'm going to send a big flood to destroy everything on the earth and start over again because everyone is so wicked." And so Noah listened to God and he began to build a big boat in the middle of dry land. And all of the other people laughed and laughed at Noah and his boat. But Noah just kept building because he trusted God, and he knew that if God had said that he was going to send a flood, then it would come, and he needed to listen and to be ready. So even though they laughed, Noah kept building. And then, one day, the clouds started to come, and it started to get dark. And then all sorts of animals started to come from all around, two by two, a male and a female of each kind. There were giraffes and elephants and tigers and lions, birds, goats, rabbits, monkeys, cats, donkeys, bears, every animal you can think of. And they all came two by two and got into the ark. And then finally, once all the animals were in, Noah and his wife and their sons' wives also got into the ark, and it began to rain, and it rained and rained and rained and flooded the whole earth until there was no dry ground at all, not even the tall mountains. Everything was covered up. But the ark and all the animals and Noah and his wife were floating safely on top of the water. And it rained for many days and many nights. And then even after the rain stopped and the clouds went away, the water was so high that they kept floating for many days and many nights. And once in a while, Noah would send out a bird. And the bird would fly around looking for dry ground, but it wouldn't find any, and so it would come back to the boat. But one day, Noah sent out the bird, and the bird came back with a branch. And so Noah knew that the waters were starting to go down and that the dry ground was coming back, and soon the ark would be able to land and the people and animals could get out. And then soon after, Noah sent the bird out again, and this time it didn't come back at all. And Noah knew that it had found a place to land. And so, after a while, the ark finally came to rest on dry ground. And Noah and his family and all of the animals came back out of the ark and started to go all over the earth to fill it back up with God's creation. And God put a rainbow in the sky a sign to Noah and his family that there would never again be a great flood like this that would cover the earth. And the rainbow was God's promise of that. And that's the story of Noah.